Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of XAMPP on a Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how to create a PHP program and how to run that with the help of XAMPP on our browser. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you're still facing any issues in the middle, you can always ask me on comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there and you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to install latest version of XAMPP on the Windows operating system, first thing that you need to do is you need to go to your favorite browser and to search over here, XAMPP download, hit enter. So that will show you this apachefriends.org. So just simply click on this download button for XAMPP and it's going to redirect to the official site of XAMPP. So this link I'm going to provide right in my description. So you can also use that link to land over here. Once when you are here, you will see that our XAMPP is available for Windows. So these are all versions that are available right now. You can always click on each of these download button with respect to its version to download that respective PHP. If you want to also use for XAMPP for browser, you can click on this run in browser. So in this video, I'm not going to talk about this XAMPP for browser. Maybe in some later video, I can talk about that. And if you're using for Linux or macOS, you can always, you know, proceed with all these different links that are there already. So yeah, so for Windows, I'll just simply click on for this version 8.2.12, which is latest version. I'll click on this download button and awesome. You can see our download will start automatically. And if you go to the previous tab, you can see that on our source fortnet, it is rightly going to start downloading, right? And you can see it is rightly started downloading. I have already have XAMPP downloaded, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory and you can see that our XAMPP is already downloaded over here. So just simply double click on this installer. It will ask if I administered the privileges. Click on yes. And there you go. Welcome to XAMPP. Here, just simply click on OK and our XAMPP installation wizard is slightly open. Let's minimize our download directory and here just simply click on next. So these are all components it's going to install, totally fine. Click on next. So this is where our XAMPP is going to be installed. So it's going to create a XAMPP folder right on our C directory and going to install all of its files over there. Alright, so I'll recommend you to keep it default and click on next. So default language will be English. If you want to change to Dutch, that also you can do. I'll keep it English and I'll click on next. So now it's ready to be installed. Click on next and there you go. Welcome to XAMPP. So you can see that our installation is rightly began. It's going to take some time, about 5 to 10 minutes I would say. So by the time it gets installed, I'll request you to subscribe our channel Geeky Script along with Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I'm posting lot of coding related videos. So don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax. And also if you're interested, you can always subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. And lastly, I want to talk about that I'm posting a lot of videos on WordPress. So if you're interested to learn about how to create an e-commerce website or how to create a simple WordPress website like a fitness gym website, so you can watch all these different videos on our channel. So you can basically watch this entire playlist, alright. So some videos are 1 hour, some are 1 or 30 minute video, some videos are a little shorter, some videos are in series. So you can watch all these different videos for completely free on our channel. Alright, so do explore our different videos on our channel. And here, let's wait for some time. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our XAMPP is rightly installed. Also, do we want to start the control panel option is rightly selected. So let's just simply click on finish. So that should be launching our XAMPP control panel. You can see it is rightly opened. So here is our start button for our Apache. So I'll just simply click on start for our Apache. So that should be starting our Apache. You can see it is rightly started and our port is also rightly assigned. So let's start for our MySQL as well. So you can see that is also rightly started. So it is up and running and our ports are also rightly assigned. If you are getting some issues on starting any of the module, so Apache or MySQL, like if you are getting some issues, then do follow this video. So I am sure if you are watching these two videos, then that should be solving your issues. Once your issues is solved and both our Apache and MySQL are actually up and running, you can just simply click on this admin button corresponding to MySQL. Just simply click on that and that should be launching your localhost phpmyadmin right on your browser. You can see it is rightly opened, right? So here you can see all these default databases that are already created. If you want to create a new database, so that also you can do, just simply click on new and give a database name, something like demo db, it's totally your choice. All right, just give a database name, click on create, and you can see a demo.db is actually created. You can create a table also. You can give as many as columns that you want, and you can create a table from here as well. All right, now I'm going to show you how to create a hello world PHP program. So first I'll go to my C drive and I'll go to this XAMPP folder, and here you will see a htdocs folder. So just simply go inside that, and here I'll just simply right click and create a new folder, and I'll name this folder as php-projects. Alright, so I'll just simply go inside that folder, and now I'll just simply right click and create a new text document, and I'll give this text document name as hello world, and I'm going to change this .txt extension with .php. Hit enter. So that will show you whether you like to change the file name extension. Yes, I want. So our file name is rightly changed. For some reason, if you are unable to see these file name extensions, all you need to do is you need to go to view, and then you need to hover over show, and then you need to enable this file name extensions. See, I have a tick mark icon just beside that. So all that basically means is my file name extensions is rightly enabled. So that's why I am getting this .txt or .php type of extension. So you need to enable that, and then you need to change this file name. Now just simply right click and open it in a notepad, and let's write a simple hello world PHP program over here. So give angular bracket and close that angular bracket, and just simply echo something like hello world, just end with semicolon, and go to file and save this file. So our file is rightly saved and created on PHP projects folder. Now all you need to do is you need to go to this PHP projects folder and right click and click on rename, show more options and rename. Just copy this folder name, exact folder name, PHP projects folder name. Alright, so now go to your browser and open a new tab and just simply type localhost, then give a slash, and then just delete this remaining thing and just paste this PHP projects over here. So localhost slash PHP projects, hit enter. So that should immediately show you all the things that are there on PHP projects folder. So here we have a helloworld.php file, so that is what it is showing, right? So just simply click on this file, and there you go, right? Hello world. So whatever you have written on your program, so that exact output will be coming right on your browser. All right. So in this way, you can easily install latest version of XAMPP and can start working on your PHP projects right on your local host. So yeah. So that is basically all about this video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel Geeky Syntax, and also if you're interested on WordPress. So as you know that WordPress are developed on PHP. So if you want to learn about how to create this type of website, like a gym website or a free e-commerce website, so then you can always watch these videos. You can watch this entire playlist as well. Alright. And lastly, special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. So that is basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.